Today is the 30th of April. It's the end of our CBA 8 conference. It ended at lunchtime today. We had two sessions in the morning. The first was a plenary session of the conference people only. We reflected on the conference, on the field visits. We had some nice FIDIC photographs shared about the field visits. And then we agreed on a way forward, which was to agree on the Kathmandu Declaration, which I'll talk about in a moment, and on pledges that people made to take the Kathmandu Declaration forward wherever they were, either in their organizations or in their countries or at international meetings and so forth. And then after the tea break, we had a formal closing where we had a number of VIPs and guests from Nepal attend. The chief guest was the Deputy Prime Minister of Nepal, and the special guest was the Chief Secretary of the Government of Nepal. We also had the Chair, the Secretary of the Ministry of Science and Technology. We had Dr. Atik Rahman, the Executive Director of BCAS in Bangladesh, Camilla Toulmin, the Head of IIED in London, and Cristiana Figueres, the Executive Secretary of the UN Framework Convention on Climate Change. They all gave very rousing speeches, and everybody finished on a great spirit. The Kathmandu Declaration was released to the media. Basically, what the Kathmandu Declaration says is three things. It's the Kathmandu Declaration on financing local adaptation. So it has three major asks, two to the global community, one to the national and subnational. The two to the global community is firstly to increase the quantum of assistance, financial input that is going into adaptation as opposed to mitigation. And secondly, of the finance that is going to adaptation at the global level, our demand is that at least 50% of it should be directed to the most vulnerable. At the global level, that means the most vulnerable countries, like the least developed countries. At the national level, that means the most vulnerable communities within countries. So our third target of advocacy are national governments, who are the ones who will decide what to do with the money they get or the money they generate themselves for adaptation. And we are asking them to allocate 50% to the most vulnerable communities, to monitor how that is spent, and to report how that is spent. And we are asking them to emulate the example of Nepal, who have decided to allocate not just 50%, but 80% of whatever they receive to the local level, to something that they have done in Nepal, a very innovative feature, was a LAPA, a Local Adaptation Plan of Action, and the government of Nepal are resourcing them. So we're using Nepal as an example. We're hoping that the Green Climate Fund will follow suit. We had the chair of the Adaptation Fund with us for the whole period of the conference, Mamadou Honadia from Burkina Faso, and they are already practicing many of the things we're asking for. So we're asking everybody to have a look at the Kathmandu Declaration, take it to heart, take it to the appropriate people, and demand that funding for adaptation is increased, funding that is available is allocated to the most vulnerable, and that at least 50% of adaptation funds go to the most vulnerable countries and people.